Kim, one of the things in my lengthy interview with Sarah Palin that I didn't get to was that you had written, and I was going to quote to her, a pretty tough column on Friday about her. And what you said, you'll say it better than I did, was basically it's not enough to inspire. You also have to perspire about the nitty-gritty, the tough issues. I'll express my opinion before I ask you. I thought she was a boffo performance today. It was the first time that I ever saw her and thought, this woman is a serious, if she decides to run, candidate for president and a serious possibility to be president. Did she change your mind at all?
I mean, Sarah Palin's always a boffo performance. She is great, and this is why people love her.
But this wasn't just,
you betcha.
She was pretty sharp on the issues.
The policies that you get, you laid out things like the economy and Paul Ryan's plan, and she gave some very specific answers. That's what she's going to actually have to do if she decides to throw her hat into the ring. And the criticism, if there is one, straightforward of Sarah Palin. This is not about her or her personality, but she's sort of a one-man show. There's a big question about her infrastructure, whether or not she has the ability to run a nationwide presidential campaign, raise the money that she would need to do this, and also her huge negatives. By putting in a lot of boffo performances over the past year, a couple of years, she has alienated a lot of voters because she weighs in on almost every issue, and that forces people to be for her or against her, and that's one of the things that she would have to deal with.
So did you see any difference today from what you've seen in the past?
She's going to have to be presidential to run, and that is going to be focusing on policies, and that's something that she has done less of as she's sort of tried to connect with voters on a personal level. She's going to have to talk policy.
John.
Well, I think the one person who really wants her in the race, I'll say something counterintuitive, is Romney. Because I think it converts it to a two-person race. And I think in the end of the day, she's basically unelectable in this country. Her negatives are already sky high. She's gaffe-prone. And I think that the point about being able to compellingly lay out specific policies that are going to be appealing to the American public are low. And so I think Romney wants to convert this to a two-person race.
You think
race.
She would clear out all I hate to use this word, underbrush, and
yeah,
she would just...
Because he's such a weak front runner against a field in which you see Herman Cain coming up, and it just takes the oxygen out of the room for a Pawlenty or anybody else. So if he can get into a two-person race between him and Palin, I think at the end of the day, the Republicans want to win, and they likely go with Romney.